Hello everyone! In this episode, we will learn about the use RevHook. As you can see, I already have our application up and running using npm start, so let's get to it. First things first, what is the purpose of the use RevHook? Well, all it does is allow us to store a mutable value that won't change whenever the component re-renders. It is something like an instance variable. The value is held in the current property. While this is the primary function of the use RevHooks, you are probably familiar with Revs as a way to access the DOM, and this is how we will use them in this tutorial. So let's start by importing the hook. I'll just add useRev next to all of our other hooks, like this. Now all I want to do is to create an input and focus that input after the initial render using the useEffect hook. First, we have to create the input reference, so I'll scroll down here and in here I'll type const input element reference, and this is going to equal to useRevHook, and the initial value is going to be null. Now let's create the input element where we will set the reference, so I'll cover it in a div, and in here input, I'll also type a placeholder, and this is going to be this should be focused, so we know what is the goal, and the ref is going to equal input element reference. Finally, let's create the useEffect hook that will focus our input after the initial render. So right about here, I'll type useEffect, pass in the function, also add dependencies, and in here I'll do input element reference.current.focus. Save, and if I manually refresh, you can see that the input gets focused. The important thing is that we are using an empty array of dependencies because we want to focus it only after the initial render. Also, as I explained at the very beginning, the value of the reference is held inside the current property, so that's why we are calling .current.focus. Now I have a small challenge for you. Try to extend this functionality by creating a button and focus the input on the button click. And that's all for this episode. In the next one, we will learn about the use callback and use memo hooks that allow us to optimize our application performance by using memoization. If you have any suggestions or questions, let me know in the comments and I'll answer every single one of them. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like and subscribe to see more videos like this in the future. Thanks for watching.